Devius. My name is Kunle Adetola. I'm the pastor of Fountain of Life, a parish of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, based in Welling Garden City in the United Kingdom. It's my honor to present to you the Open Heavens Reflection today, based on Open Heavens Daily Guide, written by Pastor E.A. Adeboye, the General Overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God. The topic before us today is Why God Sometimes Delays. Our Bible passage is taken from Genesis chapter 2, verse 21 to 22. And the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall on Adam, and he slept. And he took one of his ribs and closed up the flesh in its place. Then the rib which the Lord God had taken from man, he made into a woman, and he brought her to the man. Our memory verse is taken from Genesis chapter 2, verse 21. And the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall on Adam, and he slept. And he took one of his ribs and closed up the flesh in his place. Our reflection. In today's devotion, Pastor Adeboye explained that at times, God wants to do things in our lives without any interference from us. An example of this in today's Bible passage, where we read that God put Adam to sleep in order to create Eve. Sometimes God will let a situation continue so that we will need to depend on Him completely. It is not a delay that will harm us, but a delay that will glorify His name. God wants to turn around every situation in our lives that looks like one of shame or reproach into one that glorifies Him. He wants us to trade our sorrows and our shame for beauty. An example of a shameful circumstance can be found in John chapter 11. Two sisters, Mary and Martha, had called for Jesus to come and heal their brother, Lazarus, who was sick. Jesus did not come immediately. Rather, he waited for a few days, by which time Lazarus died. We can imagine the shame that the sisters would have felt in their community. It seemed that Jesus had failed them. No doubt they had told all their friends and neighbors not to worry, because Jesus will come and heal their brother. There are times in all of our lives that things appear to be just like that. Things appear to be dead. It appears to be over. It appears that God has turned a deaf ear to you or your cry. Your dreams are dead. It looks like God has forgotten about you. You're desperate for an answer, but no answer has come. You feel like it is too late for God to do anything concerning your situation. You feel just like Martha did when her brother died. You are too late, God. You cry out, God, where are you? But the wind picks up your cry and slaps it back in your face again. Is that where you are now? Just like in the situation of Lazarus. There will be a resurrection in your life in the name of Jesus. The story wasn't over. God still glorified Himself in an even greater way than He could have if Jesus had come while Lazarus was healed. Jesus came and resurrected Lazarus from the dead. The people had seen healing before, but they have never seen a man raised from the dead after 4 days. As a result, many became followers of Jesus that day. God will never let His name or those who hope in His name to be put to shame. Psalm 25 verse 3, in the end, God will always glorify Himself. The prayer, some delays are in your best interest. Ask God to make every delay to work in your favor. In the name of Jesus. Have a great day. The Lord bless you. Bye for now.